Peter Schiff is one of the most well-known and outspoken gold bulls who has promoted gold as a good investment for the past couple of decades, and he has rightly identified the gradual debasement and eventual demise of fiat currencies. Peter is also the CEO and global strategist of Euro-Pacific Capital. Now, one of the best ways to go long gold is not in buying gold itself or gold bullion, but by buying gold value stocks that will benefit from an upcoming bull market in precious metals. After all, if the price of gold doubles, then the share price of gold stocks can quadruple or more, as is evident looking back at the past bullish cycles gold has gone through. Today I examine the gold stocks in the Euro-Pacific Capital Gold Mutual Fund to see what Peter's top gold and silver stock selections are, so stay tuned. Hello everybody, welcome back to The Contrarian. For those of you who are new here, my name is Logan, and I really like to talk about overall success investing, as well as going against the crowd in order to outperform the crowd. You cannot outperform the crowd if you're doing the exact same thing they're doing. That's essentially what I focus on. So if you get to the end of this video and you feel like I've earned a subscription, just consider subscribing. And I'll also make a disclaimer that this is not financial advice I'm giving. This is only for informational purposes. And also, gold stocks and stocks that focus on commodities, whether they be mining or oil or whatever, they're generally higher risk and definitely higher reward. So just keep that in mind when you're keeping when I'm talking about these stocks that'll come up. So first of all, I'll just pull up this informational page. It's available on their website about the Euro-Pacific Gold Mutual Fund. And this is, I just pulled this up to see what their top gold and silver allocations are, and I'll just run through these parameters that they lay out as top priorities in these companies that they choose. So first of all, investment objectives. The investment objective of the Euro-Pacific Gold Fund is to seek long-term capital appreciation. So this is definitely not a kind of shorter-term kind of trade. This would be a longer-term allocation. Investment process highlights the fund uses a top-down approach to screen for and select attractive markets and sectors, and a bottom-up valuation approach to select securities. The fund focuses on a long-term investment horizon in order to realize value and adheres to a controlled investment process that has been similarly employed in separately managed accounts for over 20 years. So again, this isn't some sort of a short-term investment you would be making with them. But just looking at the geographic selection, they review and focus on countries that have the best fundamentals. So yeah, looking at the countries that they have most of their companies based in: Canada, Australia, then the United States, then South Africa, and then Britain, and then several others. But yeah, Canada, top, definitely almost 77%, and then Australia, United States. So very stable countries. You're not going to really have any geographic risk in those countries. Sector selection. In seeking resources with significant profit potential, the fund screens globally for attractive markets while also giving special consideration to geopolitical risk in those markets. The fund attempts to gain exposure to the best assets on a risk-adjusted basis. And the sector diversification is almost entirely in the materials sector, which is what you would expect in this exclusive gold mutual fund. And then just security selection, they select them based on attractive valuations, so just the fundamentals need to be looking very attractive for them, as well as financial strength and high business and management quality. So those are definitely good things to look for. I like to look for those as well with any investment, whether it's gold or anything else. But now getting into their top 10 holdings, they have Metalla Royalty and Streaming at over 9%, Fortuna Silver Mines at almost 9%, Oceana Gold Corp at 6.5%, Premier Gold Mines Limited at 5.3%, Osisko Gold Royalties at 4.8%, Agnico, I think it's pronounced Eagle Mines, 4.7%, Franco-Nevada Corporation, 4.6%, B2 Gold Corporation, 4.5%, Sandstorm Gold Limited, 4.4%, and Barrick Gold at 4.3%. I was a little surprised when I saw Barrick down near the bottom here, because if you'll remember, that's the gold mining company that Warren Buffett actually just bought into. So, if anything, I was expecting that to be a little up higher on their list, but it's definitely still on their, capital allocations, so that's still good in my opinion. But yeah, it's just interesting to see that there's a lot of other companies that Peter Schiff appears to think are a better deal than Barrick Gold, which is what Buffett bought into. So just a few observations on these stock selections that Peter and his other fund managers have selected is they are generally on the more conservative side, on the larger side in terms of market cap. And these companies have been selected probably, they probably have some of the best balance sheets than most other companies in the precious metals mining industry or royalties industry or whatever you're going to look at. And this is probably a good decision. I'm sure you could go with some other company that is going to be more risky, but in the long run, if you believe gold will be forced up in price as fiat currencies gradually become worth less and less, then you really can't go wrong with safer picks like these. These picks are also generally very safe geographically. They're not in a corrupt or unstable countries, so you're not going to have much exposure to geographic-related risk. Also, something important to point out is the fact that apparently Peter is not very bullish on silver, or at least not enough to allocate more than 20% to silver miners. And as for other metals such as palladium or platinum, he doesn't have any of these. So for Peter Schiff, it's gold and nothing else, or very little else, a little silver there. But, some people wonder why bother with gold stocks and the risk they pose when you could go with other value picks. And there's definitely a good point to make with that. Gold stocks are definitely cyclically driven. You're not going to have your stock appreciate if the price of gold stays the same or goes down. It's just not going to really happen. But I'll just present the argument here. So to summarize Peter's thoughts on why gold miners might go up significantly in value has to do with a very simple and methodical method of reasoning. Gold has, throughout human history, for thousands of years, been worth a consistent value. It has fluctuated some, it's gone up and down a little bit, but in terms of its purchasing power, it's pretty al much always maintained a consistent purchasing power. On the other hand, fiat currencies, which are basically any currency at this point that are printed by a central bank, they're not backed by anything. None of them are backed by gold at this point or anything with intrinsic value, and they're all just based on trust. And because of that, these currencies all eventually face a debasement and will be worth very little, if anything, in the long-term future, especially with all of the explosion of monetary supply expansion that has just occurred. I'm just looking at the US dollar and just the money supply that has occurred in the last 10 years. That's just been incredible. But a lot of other currencies like Venezuela, and there's just other examples where that's even more extreme than the dollar. So if you are in the business of mining or selling gold, which is roughly a store of value, while all other fiat currencies go down significantly in value, the earnings of, this company that's mining or selling gold will go up dramatically in relation to all of these other sinking currencies. So not only do you preserve purchasing power like you had before, but you also have the potential to gain purchasing power because with these companies, the earnings would just go through the roof, essentially. Sure, if you want to just maintain purchasing power, you can go with gold bullion, but in the long term, the stock price of these gold miners could be a very good thing to be in. So that, in a nutshell, is the bullish case for gold miners. Now, a return to a gold standard would take this to a whole different level, as all of a sudden the supply of gold would need to match the supply of dollars. So I don't know what that would be. The price of gold would have to be matched to around, I believe, $50,000 an ounce, roughly, to be equal to the supply of dollars right now. But that isn't necessarily needed for gold to go up in spot price. In past periods of rapid inflation, gold has been one of the best performing assets, such as during the 1970s especially, as well as just briefly after the financial crisis of 2008. And there wasn't very much inflation after that, just comparatively. But the main bull market recently was during the 1970s. So simply if You expect inflation to pick up and potentially run out of control, which I don't think is an unreasonable expectation. You definitely would want to be in gold assets to some extent or another. All that being said, none of this is to be taken as financial advice, and this is just for informational purposes, but I just think it's really interesting to see what Peter Schiff really is bullish about in terms of gold miners and gold royalty companies. Yeah, there's just a lot of ones out there for you guys to take a look into if you're interested in that kind of stuff. And yeah, if you like this video, just give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down. Let me know why, and I hope to see you again.